Here we're going to look at a classic number theory trick type problem. So our goal is to find the last two digits of this astronomically large number. So we've got 3 to the 7 plus 3 to the 7 squared. By that I mean 3 to the 49, not 3 to the 7, and then square that. And then plus 3 to the 7 cubed, all the way up to 3 to the 7 to the 2020. We're going to use, as a tool, Euler's generalization of Fermat's little theorem, and that says that if you've got this thing called the Euler-Totient function, so phi of n, which is the size of this set, which is all numbers between 0 and n, who are relatively prime with n, then if the GCD of a and n is equal to 1, then a to the phi of n is congruent to 1 mod n. So like I said, this is called Euler's generalization of Fermat's little theorem. I prove it in my number theory playlist if you want to check that out. Okay, then there's this nice closed formula, which I also prove in the number theory playlist, for phi of n, and it goes like this. So phi of n is equal to n times 1 minus 1 over p1 times 1 minus 1 over p2 all the way up to 1 minus 1 over pk, where these pi's are all distinct prime factors of n. So notice you don't exactly need to know the prime factorization of n to calculate phi of n, because that would also include the powers of each of the primes. You just need to know what primes divide n, which is a little bit easier of a problem to solve. Okay, so as a little bit of a warm-up, let's go ahead and calculate 5 to the 575 mod 8. So we're going to do that by using Euler's generalization of Fermat's little theorem. So the first thing that we need to do is to calculate phi of 8. You know, we can do that one of two ways. We can list the numbers 1 through 8. And then only keep the ones that are relatively prime to 8. So that would be like 7, 5, 3, and 1. That tells us that phi of 8 is equal to 4. But we can also use this formula up here. So if you notice, the only prime factor of 8 is 2. So that makes this 8 times 1 minus half. But that's 8 times a half, which is 4. So we get 4 both ways. So what that tells us is that 5 to the 4 is congruent to 1 mod 8. And we can see that because 5 and 8 are relatively prime, so that means we are allowed to apply Euler's generalization over here. So next what we want to do is divide 575 by 4. So let's see what we get when we do that. We can write 575 as 143 times 4 plus 3, like that. But next what we want to do is take this 5 to the 575 and rewrite it using this, well, really division algorithm approach. So we'll have 5 to the 575, that's going to be the same thing as 5 to the 4, all to the 143 times 5 cubed. And that's all happening mod 8, so maybe we'll put a congruent mod 8 here. Although this is strict equality at this point. Okay, good. But then, again, by Euler's generalization of Fermat's little theorem, we know that this term right here is equal to 1. But then 1 to the 143 is just 1. So all we have here is 5 cubed. But notice 5 cubed is the same thing as 5 squared times 5, so that's going to be 25 times 5 mod 8. There's obviously a lot of ways you can do this end game, but we're going to do it this way. But then notice that 25 is congruent to 1 mod 8. Because if you divide 25 by 8, you get 3 with a remainder of 1. It's 1 more than 24. So we know that number right there is congruent to 1 mod 8. So that means in the end here, we get that this thing is 5 mod 8. Okay, so now that we've done this warm-up, let's maybe get rid of this and then we'll do our goal exam. Now that we're warmed up, we're ready to look at our goal, which is the last two digits of this sum of powers of three. So let's maybe rephrase this goal in terms of a congruence mod 100, because notice the last two digits of any number are exactly what you get after dividing that number by 100 and keeping the remainder. So in other words, I can rephrase my goal like this. We want to find n mod 100. But then, by what we saw on the last board, in terms of Euler's generalization of Fermat's little theorem, we know that the exponents can be calculated mod phi of 100. So that should actually make it a little bit easier. Well, let's look at what phi of 100 is. So phi of 100 isn't too hard to calculate because 100 only has two prime factors, 2 and 5. So this is gonna be equal to 100 times 1 minus half times 1 minus 1/5. So that's gonna be 100 times 1/2 times 4/5. But you can see readily that that's equal to 40. So in other words, we need to calculate all of our exponents mod 40. Okay. Well, let's look, all of our exponents are powers of 7. So maybe if we just look at the powers of 7 mod 40, we'll see some structure here. So let's start with 7 to the first power. Well, notice 7 to the first power is congruent to 7 mod 40. And then next, 7 squared. So 7 squared is equal to 49, which is congruent to 9 mod 40. Well, it's like 9 more than 40. And then next, 7 cubed. Well, 7 cubed is going to be congruent to 7 squared times 7. But we know 7 squared is 9, so this is like 7 times 9, which is 63. But 63 mod 40 is 23. So we can do that simplification like at any step that we want. Okay, so next, 7 to the 4th, that's going to be 23 times 7. I'll let you guys check that that's 161, but that makes that 1 mod 40. But that creates our nice loop, because now we have 7 to the 5th is going to be congruent to 7, 7 to the 6th is going to be congruent to 9, 7 to the 7 is going to be congruent to 23, and so on and so forth. Okay. So that means that we can break these 2020 terms into groupings of 4 terms each, given that we're increasing the exponent here just by multiplying by 7. But we know what structure that gives us. It gives us this repetitive structure of 7, 9, 23, 1, 7, 9, 23, 1, and so on and so forth. So let's maybe write down what we mean here. So let's take our number n, and notice that our number n can be simplified mod 100 by simplifying the exponents mod phi of 100 by this chart calculation over here. So this is going to be equal to 3 to the 7 plus 3 to the 7 squared plus 3 to the 7 cubed plus 3 to the 7 to the 4th plus all the way up to 3 to the 7 to the 2017 plus 3 to the 7 to the 2018 plus 3 to the 7 to the 2019 plus 3 to the 7 to the 2020, like that. Now let's go ahead and reduce each of those exponents mod 100. Now we'll go ahead and reduce each of those exponents mod 40 by our earlier discussion, and that's going to give us that this is congruent to, so we'll have 3 to the 7 plus 3 to the 9 plus 3 to the 23 plus 3 to the 1. So again, I reduced all of these powers of 7 mod 40. But I can do that for each of these groupings of 4 because I get exactly the same thing for all of the rest of them. Okay, so this is going to be plus dot 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 plus up to 3 to the 7 plus 3 to the 9 plus 3 to the 23 plus 3 to the 1. And again, this is all mod 100. So the exponents are mod phi of 100, but the base is mod 100. And that's a really important thing for any of these types of calculations. Okay, next what we want to notice is that we've got exactly 2020 divided by four terms here, which is 505 terms. But we've got 505 terms, all of which are exactly the same. So this is going to be congruent to 505 times 3 to the 7 plus 3 to the 9 plus 3 to the 23 plus 3 to the 1. Like I said, this is all happening mod 100. Okay, so that means we need to calculate this object. Let's see if we can simplify it a little bit more, and then we'll maybe clean up the board and finish it off. So this is going to be congruent to 5. Well, look, we can just divide this thing by 100 and keep the remainder for this part of the product. And then 3 to the 7 plus 3 to the 9 plus 3 to the 23 plus 3 to the 1 mod 100. Okay, good. So I'll go ahead and bring this up and then we'll finish it off. Now we're ready to finish it off. So far we've proven that our number n is congruent to 5 times 3 to the 7 plus 3 to the 9 plus 3 to the 23 plus 3 mod 100. Now we need to get to calculate each of these. And we're gonna do these two by brute force, and then we'll calculate this one using a nice trick. So maybe to calculate these by brute force, let's start at 3 to the 5th power just so we don't have as much to calculate. So I wanna notice that 3 to the 5th power is gonna be equal to 243, but if we reduce that mod 100, we're gonna get 43. So that's a good place to start. And then next, 3 to the 6th, well, that's gonna be 3 times 3 to the 5th. In other words, it's gonna be 3 times this. So that's gonna give us 129, but then 129 mod 100 is gonna be 29, like that. Then 3 to the 7, so that's the next one that we need. So that's gonna be 3 times 29. So let's see, that's gonna be 60 plus 27, so that's gonna give us 87. Okay, so now to calculate 3 to the 8, that's the same thing as 3 times 3 to the 7. So we'll have 3 times this. Well, let's see, 3 times 80 is 240. We can reduce that mod 100 down to 40. And then 3 times 7 is 21. So that's gonna give us 61. Now we've got one left to calculate. We'll calculate this 3 to the 23 with a trick. So notice that 3 to the 9 is gonna be 3 times 3 to the 8, so that's gonna be 3 times 61. So let's see, 3 times 60 is 80, reduce that mod 100, you get 80. And then 3 times 1 is 3, so that's gonna give us 83. Okay, and then finally, we need to calculate this last bit, which is 3 to the 23. Like I said, we're gonna use a trick for this. So notice that's gonna be equal to 3 to the 20 times 3 to the 3, just using some exponent rules. And then that's gonna be equal to 3 to the 4, all to the 5th power, times 3 cubed. Okay, and then that's gonna give us 81 to the 5th power times 27. Now I'm gonna expand this like a binomial. I think this is a nice trick. So we can expand this like 80 plus 1 all to the 5th power times 27. Now next, we know that this is gonna be equal to 1 to the 5th, again expanding like a binomial, plus 5 times 80. So that would be like 5 times 80 to the 1st power times 1 to the 4th power. And then plus, everything else is going to involve an 80 squared and higher. And then all of that is multiplied by this 27, which we have outside here. Now let's go ahead and reduce all of this mod 100. So we know 5 times 80, that's 400, which is 0 mod 100. So this part disappears. 80 times 80 is 6,400, which is also 0 mod 100. So all of this part disappears. So we've got 1 times 27, so this is congruent to 27 mod 100. So in other words, we can replace this 3 to the 23 with just 27. And I'll just put a triple equal sign there, so that's 27 mod 100. So now look at what we've got. we've got our 3 to the 7 term, we've got our 3 to the 9 term, and we've got our 3 to the 23 term. Well, and then obviously we've got our 3 term, so that means we're in a good spot to finish this off. Okay, so I'll get rid of this down and we will finish it off. So we just got done calculating all necessary powers of 3 to finish this problem off. And I should say all necessary powers of 3 mod 100. So let's go ahead and make the final calculation. So here we have, this is going to be congruent to 5 times 87 plus, well, we can replace 3 to the 9 with 83. We can replace 3 to the 23 with 27. And then we'll replace 3 to the 1 with 3. That one's maybe the easiest. So we have this object to calculate. Now, let's see what we can do here. Maybe we can notice that if we take this 3 and this 87, that's gonna add up to 90. And then we can take this 83 and this 27, and that's gonna add up to 110. So 90 plus 110 is 200. So here we have, this is 5 times 200 mod 100. But that is clearly equal to 0 mod 100. So what that tells us is that this number is actually divisible by 100, which means the last two digits of our goal number are both zeros. And that's a good place to stop.